Well, it's not particularly big, but there you go. Tropic of Capricorn. Line running across here. Temperate zone here. A little bit chilly. On this side, the torrid zone. Scorching. This is the planet turned on its side. This is north. This is south. This line here is the equator. This is the Tropic of Cancer in the northern hemisphere. And this is the Tropic of Capricorn in the southern hemisphere. Look, and we've got the sun up here at the top. But this really explains what it is. The Tropic of Capricorn marks the southern boundary of the tropics region of our planet.
Longreach is famous throughout Australia as the home of the stockman. This is cowboy country, where the hats are big and farms are even bigger.
I think that worked.
But the future could be bleak for these stockmen as they face up to a crisis that may one day affect us all. I drove south to visit a local farm to find out more. It was 3 hours away, just a short hop by Australian standards. The nearby hamlet is called Stonehenge, but this is far from green and pleasant Salisbury Plain. The area is the centre of a modern-day dust bowl.
This is about as desolate as the planet can get. You look to the right, there is not a single tree or bush to the horizon.
I was in the middle of the big dry, a harsh drought that has gripped vast areas of Australia. For miles I'd been crossing a farm called Eldwick, but the weather appeared to be on the turn.
Looks as though that's rain. Whether it's enough to end the drought, I doubt it. It's a bit of an oasis out here. And here we are. This is Eldwick. Hello, hello. Hi, I'm Simon.
Yeah, I'm Donna.
Hi, Donna. Lovely to meet you. And this must be Peter. Hello, Peter. Simon. Nice to meet you. How are you?
Found us, eh?
Found you, yes.
Eldwick is a farm, or station, about half the size of Greater London. The population's a little smaller, though. Just Donna and Peter Batt, and a whole load of sheep and cows. They've been farming here for 19 years, and it seemed I might have brought a very welcome present with me.
We've just got here, and I can just feel a couple of little drips. Little bit. But this is what they say about the English. They bring the rain with them.
That'll be good. If you can organise a couple of inches, that'll be excellent.
You'd welcome that, wouldn't
yeah,
you?
We would, yeah.
Sadly, the clouds were teasing us. After a few moments of a few drips, the rain was gone.
But that is a parched land. I'm just wondering if you find it a bit... Do you find it depressing?
Well, yes, I'm just willing those clouds to, give us some rain. And, yeah, I do look out here and think, why do I live here? But there's
you
not
think,
many...
Why do you live here?
Yeah, you do.
Hmm. On the best years, when you've had enough rain, what do you see out here?
Beautiful, lush, the ground's just covered in grass. And, you know, when it's green, then when it hays off, it's that lovely yellow. We get magnificent wildflowers. It's just something you wouldn't believe. It's just beautiful.
And how many years is it since you've seen that?
Seven.
7 years?
Yep.
Seven dry years.
Seven dry years, yep.
7 years into the big dry, they're still struggling to farm this land. With the green grass gone, there's little for the animals to eat. So I headed out with Peter to feed his cows.
Maybe it's just my eyes, but they're looking at you, or they're looking at us, and they're licking their lips.
That's it. They know what we're bringing.
Here we are, sir.
Right, shovel some in there. Look,
okay.
You'll have lots
they're
of friends.
They're already
here.
They go. Here you go, ladies.
Every time I come out here, I tell them it's going to rain next week. I think they still believe me.
You tell them that every time?
Yep.
Oh, the poor girls. Some people obviously will attribute this to climate change, to global warming. What's your view?
Well, the jury's still out, I think, but...
I mean, what does it mean to you out here?
We better go and pack our port. If that's the case.
You think it will be the end?
Oh, well, I'm certainly not giving in yet, by no means, but if the rain's going to stop, well, we stop, don't we? We can't.
Have you said to each other as a couple, if we have another summer, if we have another year with no rain, we're going to have to think seriously about leaving? Have you set yourself a target at all?
Another summer without rain? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, don't know. We certainly don't want to leave. We like it. We love living here, but economics will drive us away, won't it? We're living in hope that it's going to stay green as it is.
After breakfast, I left Peter and Donna and got back on the road. The last stage of my journey, a drive east along the Capricorn Highway for hundreds of miles. Leaving the heat and the dust of the outback, I headed for the warm tropical waters of the coast. I was leaving the Dust Bowl behind, but I couldn't escape the whole issue of climate change.
In this part of Australia, they're shipping out huge quantities of coal. What a graphic illustration. We've got a train coming back empty and another one going out full. But then just a few hours to the west of here, the environment is changing.
These trains wind their way to an industrial coastline, home to one of the largest aluminium plants in the world. To find out more about how climate change might be affecting Australia, I headed east, away from the mainland.